Okay, so here we go. This is always sort of a messy process, getting switched from one type of video signal to another. So things may freeze up a little and we may have some difficulties. It's okay. This is all normal. Okay, we've got the microphone is still working. Can't hear the mini yet. Hello, Pally. Thank you for the raid. Welcome in. We're happy to have you here. Welcome to you and to your friends. We're trying to I'm trying to switch consoles here, and I'm having a great deal of difficulty. I'm sorry you've come in. I'm sorry that you've come in at the at an unfortunate time. For a brief moment, I thought I heard some SID chip sounds. Yeah, I thought I did too. I thought I heard like one beat. It came and went so quickly. I think the it's just it's just my computer that's the problem. That was, in theory, a good sound. Okay, let's try this again. Nice. Okay, this is good. We've got video, we've got audio. Wonderful. What we don't have at the moment is the game. I just noticed my USB stick is not plugged into the mini. I'm not sure where it is. There's a very limited number of areas it could be, though. So, enjoy some menu music for just a moment, my friends, and I'll be right back with you. Oh, wait. First, before I run off, Pally says, Frowny, I'm actually going to get ready for bed and lurk. Been streaming for a while to finish the game and have work tomorrow. So you finished Rayman 2 then. Well, congratulations on that, Pally. And yeah, don't worry if you need to sleep by all means. I hope you sleep well. I appreciate you dropping in, even if it's only for a brief time though, and for bringing some friends. And we're gonna play some Commodore, so we're gonna have some fun. It's just taken me a moment to get there. Finished it. It was so difficult. Have a good night and stream. I don't remember the end of that game. I know I've played it all the way through, but I really only remember the first parts of it. I'll have to try it again sometime myself. But I'm glad you made it. Alright, so like I said, let me quickly retrieve my thumb drive and then we can actually play the game. Okay, alright. Yes. I actually couldn't find the thumb drive that I've been using before, so I just put it onto a different one. Okay, we'll get that switch so that I'm facing the right way when I play the game. Think that we are about ready. Sparrow says, I happened across this game in our school computer room. I was told by my teacher if I complete some work, I'd be allowed to go play on the C64s in the computer room. With Mr. Howard, the teacher ran the computer lessons. I went in to the locked cupboard where all the games were and picked this one out. Mr. Howard trusted me that he could leave me unattended, and I spent the rest of the afternoon playing it among a few others. The whole room to myself. Sounds like a paradise, Sparrow. One more thing to adjust. Before we dive in. There we are. I had this one at home on a later Commodore we had. Would have been 8 or 9 years old, Sparrow says. I really like the music for this. I like the menu music too. I think it's pretty good. I'm gonna take it down a little bit though. All right, so one of these will be, so what I've done is I've got one copy that's regular and one copy that forces the joystick to port one. So I wasn't sure which configuration this game would require. So if we try one and I can't move anything, and then we know to just to try the other one. So we're going to try the middle file first. Right. Does this look like the right game to you, Sparrow? Definitely nostalgia invoking for anyone who played on an 8-bit machine. Especially so for C64 users, though, as the sound pulse width modulation. Was used a lot. I hope you enjoy it, Frowny. We'll see. Alright. So that wasn't actually me. This game plays a demo. Like a rather elaborate one, it seems. Pick number of cabbies. 1, 2, 3, or 4. I think that's how many players. So we're going to go with 1. Select shift. Morning, day, night, 24 hours, random. All right. Well, we're going to go with the morning because I don't know what I'm doing. And we'll begin at the beginner. Okay. All right, so I've immediately made an error. Okay, hang on. We'll get this. Okay. All right, so this is what this is gonna be like, huh? Lethal polka dots. Not sure. I think maybe this is my landing gear. I'm not sure. Am I able to change directions? Yeah, okay. I'm just not good at it. Oh, I can't turn around when that's okay. Ah, victory. I mean, he said up. If he didn't want me to crash into the ceiling, he should have been more specific. All right, it's okay. I think I've got it. This is one of 25 different screens. I'm laughing so hard. It's all right. It's all right. I think we've got it. I'm a pro. What can I say? It did say press down for instructions. Oh, what did he say? One? Pad one, please. Oh, that's why. That's what the pad thing was about. Oh. Pad two, you got it. No, I was like a pixel off. Oh, but I was going to say, Sparrow, you know I only read instructions as an absolute last resort. Bad four, please. That's right, Severity. I'm a real gamer. I'll learn by doing. Or I won't. Sometimes I'll play through 90% of a game without knowing you can charge your projectiles. That's how my most recent Castlevania 64 playthrough went. Brownie's the most chilled space taxi driver out there. Taxi trainer. What good would it do for me to lose my head? Oh, this game is great. Great recommendation, Sparrow. I've been playing it for like 5 minutes, but I already really love it. No, I really don't love messing up my landing. Six, please. There it is. That was the line in chat. What happened to me? That's all right. That was intentional. That was just a death warp, since I'm speedrunning now. Do some of the characters actually have different voices? That Hey Taxi sounded lower than the others. One small subtlety I noticed was they changed the pitch of the voice ever so slightly. That's what I'm talking about. Each voice seems slightly different. Yeah. That's nice. That's a nice touch. All right, from the top. I'm not sure how aggressively you're allowed to land. No, you're not allowed to fly into the ceiling aggressively, that's for sure. No, I can't do it. Well, you're not allowed to land that aggressively. I'm doing so much worse this time. So much worse. There we go. I'm even turned the correct direction. State-of-the-art graphics. Hey, I think it looks good. No, the car looks kind of like the it kind of reminds me of the ghost trap from Ghostbusters. Oh, I guess it is supposed to be a DeLorean. It doesn't actually look anything like that, but I'm reminded of it anyway. The ghost trap, that is. Just because they're somewhat rectangular and both slightly yellow. And made of giant pixels. No, I thought I was coming down too aggressively there. For some reason, I remember the voice wasn't quite so brash, but that might have been because I played it on the old C64 monitor that had a mono speaker on the side. I really don't want the demo to play because I don't want the level spoiled for me like that. Please. This guy always wants to go to pad one. Next time I catch a taxi, up, please. No. I was doing really well. It's a shame for it to all fall apart like that. Oh, all the way back over here on pad one, huh? I knew I was too low. I was too low. I knew I was doing the wrong thing, and yet I did it anyway. Pad three, here we go. No, I missed. I'm just going to pretend this is the guy I was supposed to drop off on pad three. I'm going to pretend like I was successful. More bots. I really am gonna have to do something about them. This game gets us some quality frowny nose. That does seem to be my catchword. It was gain popularity this time, not famous. What? Really? It said something different? What's that F down there? I think I want that F. Looks like a bag of money. F for fair. No, why? I've never worked as a taxi driver, but I imagine it's a bad strategy to hang out at the place where you dropped your previous customer off, waiting for someone to yell to you from across town for your next fare. Like, I imagine that I should be on the move pretty much immediately, but instead I just gotta sit here and wait. All right, we're going to that F. Sorry, guy on pad 9. I've got to know. Oh, it's fuel, and it's mandatory. Oh, thank goodness I investigated. We're never going to make it over here to 9. No, I was almost wrong. I wish I'd been wrong. Don't like this guy on pad 9. He caused me a lot of misery. F for fuel, not F for frowny. I thought it was going to be bonus money. I thought it was F for fair. This is an absolute joy to watch. I'm so happy, Sparrow. I'm so glad you're having a good time. I'm having a good time too. I really like this game. I have a feeling we're gonna be like stuck seeing a lot of the same stuff, but still fun to play. Add one. No, don't go up that high. Don't go up that high. No, it all fell apart. What do you think this drink is on the beach chair? It's I guess it's limeade because it's green. Space Taxi's kind of a weird name because it's kind of like miniature flying taxi because we're in like oversized worlds. Is this a Japanese game? It might be cream soda. Their cream soda is green? A rancid pina colada? No. I think cows would say every pina colada is rancid. It was yellow in 1984. Maybe the alien worlds you're visiting are just giant compared to you. I mean, this world does look normal sized. So I guess we are not always miniature, but. I vaporized him. I guess I should move, huh? How many customers did I just vaporize? By refusing to move. Oh. Spawn camping is a reality in this game. Nope, I knew I was gonna miss that. Again, by just like a single pixel. Oh no, I vaporized him again. No, I vaporized myself. Look at that. We don't actually start off with a score of 0. We start off with a score of 1 cent. You don't even have to play the game and you've already earned money. Hey. Here we go. Pad 9, my mortal nemesis. Nope. I took a second to glance at my fuel gauge, and it was enough to ruin me. Oh, I don't need fuel now. I'm not happy about that. You know why that is. If you have money, they can tax you, so you've always got money. Maybe Frowny is finding the game a bit taxing. I'm quite thoroughly tickled by this. It's great. I wonder if Frowny's keeping taxidermy of all the customers he sacrificed. How could I? I de-atomize them when I destroy them. There's nothing left to taxidermy. Please. The customers are also polite. Pad 2 is not my favorite pad to go to. Nice work, thank you. I'm just hoping I can keep it up, but this stage has really been tough for me. Pad 9. You madman. I love that they have different voices. Oh, he's way over there. Sorry, I gotta get fuel. I'm never gonna make it to you in time. Why is this pad so narrow? Pad 6. Oh, I was really hoping you would have said up. I heard ya. Up. Okay, I gotta be careful. I gotta be careful. Real, real careful. No. Oh, it was a flawless performance. Until it suddenly wasn't. At least they didn't make you do the entire level again. That would have been immensely frustrating. What is going on here? Oh, of course he had to be all the way on the other side. It's growing. One of these is a, I hope one of these branches that grows out is a fuel branch. Pad one. You don't even want to go over there. You're just trying to cause me misery. See, pad 8 is more like it. I just screamed the house down. That was quite a tragic turn of events. Pad 9, what a gentleman. I've got to fly over this guy. What are you doing standing at the edge of the branch, man? It's like you want me to hit you with my thrusters. Black Jellybead, welcome to the stream and thank you for the follow. Very happy to have you on board. There are obstacles in this game. No, it's coming for me. Okay. So it looks like if you landed, you're okay. But I don't know that I want to test that. No. Thank you for the trophies. No. What am I doing? I was so scared of the ping pong ball that I just flew right up into the ceiling. Oh, this game gets hard. One of the top 10 cabbies of all time. I don't remember how to do the virtual keyboard. Victory is sweet. Truly a life's achievement. 145 dollars, and I'm one of the most successful cabbies in history. This might be the point that I gave up, by the way. I certainly have not finished this game. This game is gonna take me a while. I've got a feeling we're gonna be working on this for a lot of nights. So I put Atari 2600 and C64 on the schedule for Friday, and so I was thinking at Atari 2600, I need to play E.T. and Zippy. I need to try and work on both of those, and I didn't really know what I was going to do on the C64, and now I think I know what I'm going to do. I'm going too slow. No, I've become overconfident. We're gonna have a lot of like really like foolish deaths until I relearn my humility. Thank you. It's terrible when you see the mistake. But can do nothing about it. No, I came down and I fell to pieces. Everything is so pixelated, and when we perish, our pixels scatter in such a way that suggests to me that everything is really built out of Lego in this universe. So, I'm curious. I'm expecting that the standard 24-hour shift means you play through 1, 2, and 3 back to back. And I'm pretty sure that the random 24-hour shift means that you play through. Well, it could mean that you play through 1, 2, and 3 in any order, but I would hope that it would mean that you play through all the stages of 1, 2, and 3 in any order. But I don't know if it shuffles the levels like that. I really hope it does. It'd be a nice way for us to get to see some different levels, maybe earlier than we deserve. Had one. The doors to the buildings are just two windows painted a different color and stacked on top of each other. I don't think they're fooling anyone. Oh. What a prince! This is my favorite guy in the game. Before we start this next level, I want to remind you that the pad you pick to travel to says a lot about who you are as a person. And I want all of you to think about that before you go choosing to travel to pad 9. No! We've evolved from gentleman to prince now. This guy down here is the opposite of both of those. I heard you. This guy gets really pushy whenever I stop for fuel. Do you know what happens when I run out of fuel? Do you want to be along for the ride when that happens to me? Thank you. Having a bad time here. It's pretty great that the first stage is called Short and Sweet, and that it is both very short and candy themed. I'm sure glad the space taxi can land on clouds. Ah! I mean, look at this guy. He's walking on a cloud. You know what this reminds me of? This game kind of reminds me of Bubble Ghost. Thank you. fuel situation is starting to get a little dicey. This guy better not want to go to 9. Great place, guy, on pad number 2. Here we go. It had to be coming. Whoa. If we can get to this guy and not explode, and he says up, please, I'm going to be so happy. Yes! But will I make it? Will I make it? The perfect run! The dream is real! Thank you for the trophies. Here we go. I knew this situation was coming. And here we are, right at the start. I wonder if they can request a pad that hasn't spawned yet, and then I just have to sit and, like, wait. I don't know what that beeping is about. Oh, that's when a beanstalk branch finishes growing. Oh, he's all the way over there. All right, pad 5, sure. At 8, 8 is great. Yes. Oh, we're back here again. Taxi Pong, what an awful game. Whoever invented Taxi Pong is a real monster. Thank you. No, I'm destroying him again and again. No, why? I was a real expert, and now I'm a real loser. That ping pong ball, it makes me so nervous that I just don't remember how to function. We get to see a new screen. Teleports. Oh my. What happened? Hang on, what happened to me? I guess I messed up my landing. I picked a bad time to glance away. And yes, I agree. This really is something to look at. Puzzler. Well, this is really something. No, why'd it grow back? Well, here we go. Look at that. I think I have to put in. Something, or it won't. Oh, it won't let me put in a symbol. It only lets me put in letters. All right. Well, let's go down here to random 24-hour shift and see if it does do levels in a random order. So we might see a lot of the, like, more challenging levels. But I want to see if that's what this is. This is impossible. This is impossible. The platforms are moving. No one can do this. I'm supposed to get all the way down there to pad 7 in less than 20 seconds. You pass through the chains. I didn't really think you could, but... Whoa. I think the game froze up. I don't think I've ever had that happen before. That was weird. All right, here we are, teleports. All right, I know this level. turbocharged taxi. Oh no. Oh no, am I gonna go super fast everywhere? It changed my physics. The game's hard enough with the regular physics. Not only am I turbocharged, but I run out of fuel super fast too, it would seem. I mean, I guess, sure, that makes sense. It takes more fuel to go faster. Something is wrong with the landing on this screen. Okay, so let's see what happens standard 24-hour shift. Is it going to be the same? All right, so it's the same levels. It's all the levels in the same order. And now I'm all messed up from the other physics. Thank you. No. It's nice that when you move in between screens, on the new screen, the first fare, the one that you bring with you, always wants to go to pad one. But that all the rest are random in where they appear and where they want to go. I like that. It's always so satisfying when the taxi goes up through the top hole. Agreed. What do you think about the between level transitions where the taxi just kind of flies back and forth? Like, it looks like it should be zooming, like, away from the screen. So it's weird that they didn't bother to make a sprite of the rear view of the taxi. Space drifting. I thought it was dodging the little sparkles. I think it's just supposed to be zooming away from the camera. Love this guy. The guy who lives at pad four and only wants to go to pad three. Best guy. Maybe it's driving up a space switchback mountain. Really like that both games that we played tonight had amazing voice acting. Always hurts so much more when you're doing so well. I disagree. How did I mess that up? I mean, I kind of know what I did, but I can't believe I did it. You want to rethink your pad choice? Didn't you learn anything? That was a really rough landing. I'm surprised we survived that. What was that? I don't know what I don't remember what I said, Master Tuesday. That was a rough landing. I'm surprised we survived. You're right. You're right. I love the victory music. I feel like 184, that might be the most money that we've earned. That's definitely not the best I've played. The first time we saw this plant stage, I thought it was going to grow so much that it would block you eventually. And even though I know it won't do that, I still worry about it for half a second every time. I know the feeling. I had a very similar worry. Cows. Alright, we're going to make one, maybe two more attempts. I think we'll just stick to the, but you know what, we'll do a day shift attempt just to see what some of these levels are like, and then we'll come back and we'll do another morning shift. I don't expect I'm going to make it very far. And look at this. Space taxi in a war zone. There are so many more projectiles, and they're random, and yet I feel like this is easier than the ping pong stage. The ping pong stage has one projectile at a time, and it moves in a predictable path. And yet it's so much harder than this one. This guy probably wants to go to 7. He wants to go up. That's even better. Wow, I thought that level was going to be impossible, and it wasn't bad at all. No. Oh, I thought the stars were eating away at the land like Space Invader bullets, but unfortunately, no. Oh, come on. Please tell me you just want to go to 4. You're my hero. I come back from the shops and Frowny's a pro. I mean, not really, Sparrow. I just decided to try a different level category. I haven't beaten an actual space-related theme. Could it be? I haven't beaten the beginner category yet, but we made it pretty far. We made it, like, 6 or 7 screens in, and I expect there are only, well, maybe not 7, maybe 6. Or I think the Yeah, the training one is 4, the beanstalk is 5, ping pong is 6, teleport is 7. We got through teleport. What was the last one? I don't remember what was after the teleporters. So we did. We made it to the eighth stage. That was probably the last stage then. Moving conveyor nonsense. No, that was in the random category that I got the moving conveyor nonsense. Magnets. These magnets are really something to fear. Right, back to the beginner stage. It's waiting for him to say pad 4. Why pad 4? Because there wasn't one on that screen. Okay. I think that only happens if your copy of the game is haunted. The other copy of Space Taxi that I had, Sparrow, was this. It's the exact same. It doesn't have the Joyport modifier. Because I didn't know if this was a port one or port two game, so I put one copy for either port. I don't know of another game called Space Taxi, but I didn't know about this one, so there could be, but I don't have it. Sorry, guy on pad 9, I need gas. Oh, the fuel costs you money. I mean, I guess that makes sense, but think I'm just gonna hang out and let that guy go away. There's not enough time. Oh, he doesn't go away. I just have to do it for free now. That's not how being a taxi driver works, right? No. Oh, I'm very unhappy with how things are going now. I feel like this is the most trouble I've had on this level. I don't feel like this one has been particularly difficult historically. And this time it's going very poorly.
Oh, this is garbage. This is nonsense. Space taxi. Why? Oh, I'm so unhappy. This is so frustrating and disappointing. We made it here with, like, almost all of our lives, and now we've lost them all. Oh, space taxi. Why did you do this to me? What happened to the good times when we were still friends? I'm gonna have to call it a night here. No worries, cows. That's actually what I'm about to do. So yeah, thank you very much, my friends, but this is going to be the end of our stream. It has been a good time. Altered Beast was way more fun than I thought it would be, and this game is tremendously fun as well. We'll definitely be playing both of them again. We had no victories tonight, but we had a lot of, we had a lot of small victories, but no big victories. A lot of small victories, though, so a lot to be happy with. Space Taxi is a good time, and I'll come back to it. I think I'll be able to beat the beginner segment and the intermediate segment. The expert segment, I don't think I will ever be good enough at Space Taxi to do that. I'm assuming that the platform, the moving platforms level, was expert. If that was an intermediate stage, I will never beat the intermediate stages. That moving platform stage looked to be like a special kind of disastrous. So we're going to wrap up the stream here, my friends. Thank you so much for viewing. Thank you so much for chatting. I really appreciate your company, and I hope you'll join me again. Tomorrow night, we're going to work on Mission Impossible and Doom 64, both on the Nintendo 64. I didn't do any Contra or Super C tonight, so there's a very good chance that I will do one or both of those tomorrow. So we'll have a lot of different games on the stream. If you would stay on the line with me, we will go on a raid together. Assignment improbable. I gotta be here for that. That's the plan, to work on that tomorrow. Cheers, Frowny. I'm glad you enjoyed this. It's really good, Sparrow. Excellent. Excellent pick. I'm really glad you shared this game with me, because it's a lot of fun. So, let's... head off together. I think we'll head in the direction of Bel Air Jeff. He was here keeping us company. He's been here keeping us company a lot, but he was here earlier tonight, and now he's live. He's going through all of the Castlevania games, and he's up to the PlayStation 2 era now. I haven't played any of the PlayStation 2, either of the PlayStation 2 Castlevanias, so I won't be able to watch too much too closely for fear of spoilers, but it will be nice to go over there and hang out for a while. Alright, my friends, so as we head off, I just want to tell you to take care until we get to see one another again. I hope that's very soon, but for now I'm going to see you on the other side of the raid.